الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. As we close up this ayah, just like in the beginning there were three descriptions of the Quran, three states, now at the end you have three purposes of the fasting. Three purposes of the fast. Like the three roles the Quran plays and the three roles that Ramadan plays. That's how the ayah is actually ending. And the first of them I told you, so that you perfect the count, so that you complete the count. And we talked about that in the last session. That is the first goal of the giving of Ramadan. That's for your benefit. The second goal, which is what we're going to talk about today, or in this session, is وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, so that you declare Allah's greatness based on how He, based on His guidance to you, based on how He guided you. Okay? So you, that phrase is a little bit loaded. You declare Allah's greatness based on how He guided you. Now, this is a simple explanation of that. When you finish the count, 30 days, then there's Eid. When you're going to Eid, what do you say? You declare Allah's greatness. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Everybody going to the Eid prayer is declaring Allah's greatness. So obviously we're doing that literally, we're pronouncing that greatness at the end of the month of Ramadan. And that makes sense logically here, because he says complete the count and then declare Allah's greatness the way He guided you, meaning through the legacy of the Prophet ﷺ and the Eid prayer. But there's something more than just that ritual that's being talked about here. For 30 days, you trained yourself to recognize Allah's greater authority over your own body, over your own preferences, over your own tongue, over your own eyes, over your own thoughts. You declared Allah's greatness over all of those things, and you tried to perfect each of those days. Now that these 30 days have been completed, the purpose of this month is that you can continue to declare Allah's greatness in what He guided you, meaning after fasting is over. Don't all of you feel, when fasting is over and you're about to just have lunch and you're just about to reach for that burger, you stop for a second, wait. Oh yeah, whew, so much easier now. Like there's this relief that things have gotten easier, you understand? Allah is teaching us, I'm not asking you to fast all year. So the things I want you to stay away from are not that hard. You were able to do much harder for 30 days. Now, based on the guidance I've given you, the things that you should not go near and declare my guidance to you greater than all of those things, and you'll be able to prioritize and get away from the impermissible, and get away from things you shouldn't be saying, and get away from things you shouldn't be looking at, and get away from monies that you shouldn't be earning, behavior that you shouldn't be doing, get away from harming other people, backbiting, slandering, get away from trying to ruin somebody else's life. You're going to get away from those things because that's much easier to do now. He says, I gave you these 30 days so you really truly understand what it means when you say Allahu Akbar, when you say Allah is greater. Of course, Allahu Akbar is something you hear in the adhan, is what you hear in the prayer. Think about the psychological effects of Allahu Akbar. When the Muslim hears Allahu Akbar, that means, you hear the adhan, right? And you're busy like working on your school project, or somebody's in the middle of lunch, or somebody else is just talking to their friend. They hear the adhan, hey, I gotta go, it's prayer time. You wrap up the lunch quickly, you go. You finish your project, or you say, I'm going to put the project on hold, I'm going to go. Meaning for Allah is not just the greatest, it actually means Allah is greater. What does that mean? Allah is greater than my lunch. Allah is greater than my conversation with my friend. Allah is greater than my nap. Allah is greater than this movie. Allah is greater, Allah is greater, Allah is greater. You drop those priorities. That's why it's the comparative form. You drop those priorities and join the prayer. When you join the prayer, you say, Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater. And then every motion you take is not the motions you do in your life. If somebody started talking to you while you were praying, you wouldn't say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Rahmani. Hey, hold on, bro, let me just finish this. Allah is greater now for those moments until the prayer is done. Nothing else disturbs you. Your eyes don't go wandering. Your tongue doesn't go wandering. Your mind isn't supposed to go mad. Your hands are submitted. Your limbs are submitted. The motions of your body are submitted because you recognize that Allah is greater. When Allah says here, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, so you declare Allah's greatness the way He guided you. One implication of that is, of course, from now on, you'll be committed to your prayers. Because the greatest declaration of Allah's greatness is the five prayers. From now on, don't skip out on them prayers. Ramadan, those 30 days, you were able to pull it off. Now don't skip on those prayers. Truly declare Allah's guidance the way He guided you. Allah's greatness the way He guided you. Two, what I mentioned in the beginning, now your priorities are going to be dictated by Allah. You're not going to think of your preferences as greater than what Allah wants for you. And that leads me to that last point. Ala ma hadakum. When you declare Allah's greatness based on how He guided you, what that means is, my preferences, my opinions, my thoughts, my feelings are sometimes going in a different direction. And what Allah is telling me, after I've properly understood what Allah is telling me, after I've properly understood it, sometimes my feelings, my thoughts, my priorities are going in a different direction, and what Allah wants is going in a different direction. What does it mean to say Allahu Akbar? It means my preferences cannot be greater than Allah's position on this. So I'm going to submit my preferences. You know, حَتَّى يَكُونَ هَوَاهُ تَبِعًا لِمَا جِئْتُ بِهِ, the Prophet said. Nobody believes until they took their what they desire, what they feel, and they bring it under what I have brought, meaning the Quran. لِتَكُونَ كَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا, so the word of Allah could be in the highest place. You and I have to figure that out in our personal lives. Nobody can do that for you. You have to think about what Allah is saying yourself, and where are you contradicting? Am I contradicting what Allah wants? And am I allowing myself to be greater than the word of Allah? Allah says the purpose of the month of Ramadan is truly to declare Allah greater, based on how He guided you, meaning based on His words. Are you weighing His words heavier or your preferences heavier? That's really the question you're going to have to ask yourself, and I'm going to have to ask yourself. And that's the training Allah has given us so we can bring ease into our lives. You know, you might think that obeying Allah is going to make things harder. I can promise you, all the difficulties in your life are in Allah's control. All of them. And you submit yourself to Allah, and He's in charge of removing your difficulties. And even if He doesn't remove your difficulties, He's in charge of giving you the strength, the ability, the versatility to be able to stand against all of those difficulties. He will give you that. You can't get that on your own. You're never going to get that on your own. But you will get that if you become completely submissive and understand the greatness of Allah over yourself. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us all those who truly mean Allahu Akbar when they say Allahu Akbar. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.